Because if you know how to code, you know how to code. And then teaching their language to a programmer isn't particularly that hard.
It's a little different than other degrees because it's more practical related than theoretical. It's a piece of software that runs now on a mobile device that can run on a very large computer, run on a computer like this, a desktop. So when you look around and you see people selling insurance or keeping the lights on with utilities or shipping stuff or whatever, how do you leverage information technology to do those types of things? And we teach more of that piece than how computers actually work. The BAS programs are normally degree completion, so we require that people come in with either a two-year degree or the equivalent number of units, like 90 quarter units. So they have to have 2 years of college before they get in.
It was the program here at North Seattle College that really offered me the most for the minimal amount of time investment. Considering that I already had a bachelor's degree, it was very easy to come to this program since it only requires you to spend 2 years here. So it's very affordable.
All the classes are done in the evening from 6 to 8:40.
So it's very easy to fit it into your schedule if you are working during the day.
We have three major areas that we train in. One is in web development, one is in mobile development, and then cloud development. So there's a class on that, and in the next term, the following term, there's what we call practicum. So we're building something for somebody.
The curriculum here is very project-centric. So many of the classes that the students are required to take focus around some sort of project that is similar to what you would find working on in the real world.
Our program is cohort-based, so we only start people in the fall, and they travel through all their classes with the same group of people, which makes it a whole lot easier when you start doing group work because you know your fellow students.
Yeah, there's a lot of eagerness that comes out of these students, and they just have this gung-ho attitude of, like, we're going to build something great. And that's kind of the enthusiasm that also is kind of highlighted in industry hires.
We have structured this program in such a way that if I get input from industry saying, you know, you really ought to start looking at this, I put that in the work right away. How the industry evolves gets mimicked, if you will, or copied into this curriculum very rapidly.
Small class sizes, great instruction, and all the essential skills you need, plus, obviously now, industry advisors who can help make sure the curriculum is fresh. It's a great thing.
There's internships, which is great for people who have little or no professional experience. We also have something called a capstone, which is a project they can do on their own or with one or two other people, because there's people who work already and can't give up a good paying job to go to a low paying job for an internship.
I have had great success with internships in the past, and so I was looking forward for the opportunity to become involved as an intern working in the industry. Right now, I have an internship with T-Mobile, and I'm currently working on the e-services team, doing some work on the customer-facing payment site.
But for a lot of people, the internships lead directly to jobs. If not at that place, at some other place because of what they've learned. But a lot of people have went from an internship to a full-time position right afterwards. Apple's here, Google's here, Disney's here. Obviously, Amazon's here, Microsoft is here. Seattle's kind of the new tech area for the United States. So it just makes more sense to be able to produce people locally.
There's tremendous demand. And usually what I tell people is it's sort of like the expansion of the universe. It's expanding in all directions. So I think the biggest challenge that a lot of people have coming out is really deciding where to focus.
What we saw at first were people who were really like into the industry or really into programming. And now we're seeing people who are career changers. People know our students now, and people know what they're capable of. The idea is, can I get a job that makes really good money? And our students are getting jobs that are in the $70,000, $80,000 range after they graduate.
Incredible. I feel more personally fulfilled in what I'm doing now. Obviously, this is an in-demand industry, and it's no secret that it pays well. My quality of life has increased substantially. And beyond that, it's been a wonderful thing for my family.
The industry says is if you can code, that's what matters. It doesn't matter so much where you got your degree from, it's what you know, and the skills that are taught here are top-notch.